Auburn lines up to kick this one off, and we're just about set to get underway. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Penn State's coaching staff so confident, they know they've got a guy that's one of the best running backs in the country and that they can just play their game and not worry about the fact they're on the road.
Well, Brett, his big playability not only can give you big chunks of yards on the road, but more importantly, it can quiet this atmosphere and allow the quarterback in this offense just getting back and just being able to run and be able to communicate. And that's a big challenge for this team. So look for his big playability to maybe even out the atmosphere and give this offense a chance to be able to execute.
So the sack makes this a second and long. He's on the run. Now he's going to run and watch out. He's taken down.
Right around the 24-yard line.
The quarterback didn't see anybody open downfield, so he took it himself and picked up some decent yardage.
Here's third and 11. Ball on the 24. He gets sacked on the play. Excellent punt. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. The ball changes hands on the punt. Nice opening stand by the defense.
I'm sure the fans are thrilled to see their guys come up with an early stop in this game and see if the offense can give them something else to get excited about now.
They'll drop him for a loss.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
Second down and 12. Ball on the 44-yard line. And down he goes at about the 45. The stop at the 41.
They had a long way to go, and the receiver managed to just get enough to pick up the first down.
And he just gets rid of it. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 41. Taken down right around the 40. Call it a game. Right, 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 right. That'll make it 39. Check back 40. Check back 40.
Yes, let's go, Bill. Yes, yes, yes.
This quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
Kicks away, and it hits the upright. No good. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. He makes his way to about the 48.
Very well-designed play that time to give him a first down. The linemen executed their blocks nicely, and it went for a good game.
From the 48-yard line, first down. Tackle right around midfield. The D lineman wasn't letting anyone by him that time.
And the big fella did a heck of a job plugging up the hole where that play was supposed to go.
receiver dropped.
The pass was right on target, so that took a perfectly timed hard hit to knock it free. Strong defense to deny the completion.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 38. Gets it. He's in space. Tackle made at the 21-yard line. What a play.
What a play is right. Here they throw the ball to the tight end, and the big guy shows that he's valuable not only as a blocker, but as a receiver as well. Nice catch.
Hit on the throw. He caught it. What a play, and that is first and goal.
That's good for 12 yards.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. He fights forward to about the 7. Third and goal from the 4, and this would break the tie. So they get about 4 yards from play action.
All it takes is a second on these play action fakes to get the defense out of position. That's how this tight end was able to get open and pick up some yards.
Makes the PAT. A nice 9-play, 59-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Strike complete. He's down.
That makes it 2nd and 6.
Mike 40.
Slam.
Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete. It's 3rd down and 6 to go. Ball on the 29-yard line. Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete.
That pass didn't look exactly right when it left his hand. Sometimes you don't get a great grip on the ball and it comes out a little wobbly.
These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. He really got a hold of that one. Nice yardage on the run back. The quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and he led a great drive last time out. Penn State is up by a touchdown. And he's tackled right away. A little toss across the middle.
He made a good read here to find his teammate. That's sound decision making.
Exciting first quarter comes to an end. The Nittany Lions with a touchdown lead. Back to the action now here in the 2nd quarter.
Four down. Mike five.
zips it to the tight end. So they complete that for about 4 yards, and they'll pick up a first down.
I think they were expecting a run on that play, Brad, and it allowed the quarterback to throw for just enough yards to get the first down.
And he hits him hard at the 37-yard line.
Sometimes a play is not going to work for whatever reason. Doesn't mean you throw the play away. You just need to execute better next time.
From their own 37-yard line, second down. He rifles it to the right.
That could have been a huge shift in momentum if they were able to hold on to that one.
Wow, that was close.
That makes it 3rd and 15.
Gets it out quick, and it's going the other way.
I'm really impressed with this guy's closing speed on the ball. He's got the kind of jets you need to be a standout corner.
From the 50, first down. Line. 6 yards that time on the pass play.
It's a decent pickup that time on a well-designed play.
He's at the 30. He's tackled around the 23-yard line.
Good solid running right there. Getting past the defensive lineman and into the secondary before he could be stopped.
Complete. He's got room to work. They'll bring him down at the 5. Now he's scrambling. And he's level at the 2. He got 3 yards there on the scramble. The PAT to tie this thing up. And he tacks on the extra point. A 6-play, 50-yard drive, and they get it in for 7. We get a tie game at 7-7. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Their last drive ended with an interception. We're about to find out what the defense can do this time.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
Throws, and it's knocked away.
He was able to just tip that one away, right out of the receiver's reach.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. He's wrapped up for the sack. From their own 24-yard line, it's third down.
Orange 3, orange 2.
Steps up, wants to go long, and does. A Oh, boy, almost intercepted. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. And he's taken down at the 27-yard line. So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
He makes his way out to about the 35. Around the 45-yard line.
You talk about a dual-threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
Here's the give. He makes his way to about the 45. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. The 10. Touchdown, Tigers. And that's his second touchdown of the day.
This is a defensive coordinator's worst nightmare, is having to defend a quarterback that has an ability to run the football. He's already scored twice in his first half, and the defensive coordinator needs to start accounting for him and his ability to run the football.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Auburn ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He gets rid of this one. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. He's going to try and scramble, and they bring him down for a sack on the play. That makes four sacks today.
Well, this speed is difficult to defend because you have to try to keep them off balance so they can't use their quickness.
Gets out to around the 28. The offense couldn't get anything going that time.
No, they couldn't. They really looked out of safe there. They're going to have to make some adjustments to come back next time out.
Puts it away, and it's a great kick. Tackle made at the 35-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Auburn up 7 points. He's taken down at the 49. Tries to buy some time. And he's immediately tackled. Just throws this one away. He He's going to try to coffin corner this one. Oh, excellent punt. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Got it, and brought down immediately. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Three down.
Mike, five.
Dog, four. X, seven. Check. Dancer. Hit.
Quick throw, and he's got his receiver again. And down he goes, right around the 36-yard line. A great first half comes to a close. The Tigers with a touchdown lead.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half.
Let's not get too carried away by the numbers, but both of these teams averaging less than 6 yards per pass. It's an indication, it seems, that maybe there's not the personnel out there that really scares this defense, that can really stretch the defense.
Yeah, we talk about it all the time, having those big-time speed guys and those playmakers on the outsides that really make the cornerbacks bail and take away the deep ball. And they're not scared right now. They're just squatting on the outside and saying, you're not going to run by me. You're not going to throw it deep. And all I'm going to do is try to make sure that you catch the underneath stuff and wrap you up and tackle you. So somebody has to emerge as a playmaker, and you have to find the playmakers down the field to make some big home run plays.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. It'll be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Auburn is up 7. And he's taken down around the 35-yard line. Around the 42-yard line. He's going to go for the home run. He's got it. Touchdown. Pass and a nice catch.
Well, this is one of those plays you just sit back and admire. The quarterback threw the ball perfectly, and again, the speed of the receiver is the difference in this play.
That's perfect timing between a quarterback and a wide receiver. He recognized the middle of the field was wide open, and I really thought the quarterback kind of looked the safety off to open that play up to the middle and then made the perfect throw for the touchdown.
And he converts the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. Auburn's coaching staff will go out tonight, and I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. A 1 yard loss.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
From their own 24-yard line, second down. He's to the 40, at the 30, to the 20, to the 10. Touchdown, big play. He's had a good game, snaring passes for 100 yards.
Well, he's such a big target with good speed, and that's what makes him a dangerous part of this offense.
And he adds the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And they can forget about returning this one.
Both teams have really answered the bell here in the third quarter, Kirk.
Well, exciting to see what these offenses have been able to do here. Be able to come out and score in your first drive tells you a lot about what they did during the half. The quarterback did a really good job in the last drive of finding his receivers in space, and I bet he'll be looking to do the same thing again.
Auburn is up a score. There's a strike complete. He's down. Dumps it out left to the running back. That's a great tackle at the 38. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Tackle made at the 49-yard line. Hands it to the back, and they get nice yardage on that run. And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
The offense knows that the linebackers are cheating up a little bit on the run. If they can get some protection, they might want to open up a little bit of space for some passes underneath.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 41. He flings it. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it.
Number 4 is the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up fourth and 9.
Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to change field position. He gets it away. This is a really nice punt. This one will go into the end zone and they'll bring it out to the 20. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Here's a little draw play, and they make the stop at about the 21. From their own 21-yard line, second down. A nice run up the middle.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. Third down.
And he's going to come up with a sack.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit for the quarterback. It'll be interesting to see how he responds from his hit, whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges him to start playing a little bit better.
And this one is a beauty. Nice yardage on the run back. Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here. Auburn is up by a touchdown. They'll knock him down for a loss.
Well, give the defense all the credit here. They had that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
From their own 44-yard line. Second down. He gets rid of this one.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Hauls it in. They'll bring him down at the 48. That series left the offense scratching their heads a little.
The defense is going to head to the sideline with a real sense of accomplishment, knowing that they've just shut this offense down.
He's going to aim this one to the sideline, try to kick it out of bounds. It's away, and it's a booming punt. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. For Auburn, they've been getting into the backfield quite a bit. This defense has been bringing the blitz and is having success getting to it.
They also have that one takeaway.
This offense's best bet seems to be to keep the ball on the ground.
No, they haven't. So maybe they should just focus a bit more on the running game to mix it up and keep the defense guessing.
We're probably going to get an earful from this crowd, hoping to add to the offense's concerns. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings them second and five.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Looking to scramble down. He can't get away from the pressure. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. He's tackled at the 18-yard line. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He's taken down at the 40-yard line. They were lucky to prevent a big return there.
Yep, that could have been big if he could have gotten a few more blocks and was able to find the seam.
And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Auburn up 7 points. Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off. So at the end of the third quarter, Auburn in front, 21-14. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. Offense lines up in a 5-wide set, and the defense anticipating pass here. Fires out to his receiver, and he hits him hard at the 48-yard line. Quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, 5 wide receivers in the formation. Throws in the middle, and he's tackled at the 41-yard line.
He gets out to about the 38-yard line. And he gains around three on that keeper.
You're not going to be able to get by a sure tackler like this linebacker too often.
Tough throw on the run and caught. Brought down around the 36-yard line.
Well, they didn't need too much on that play. And let me tell you, they didn't have any room to spare because they barely picked up the first down.
To about the 27-yard line. Here's a quick throw. Throws to the receiver. Got it for the touchdown. Tacks on the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. The Tigers have really been all over the place. They're playing like a defense possessed.
I love to watch a defense just pin its ears back and just fly to the football. They are playing with a reckless attitude, and it's really paid off because it's set up their offense to be able to score points.
It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold? He's taken down at the 25-yard line. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball in the 25. Fires complete over the middle. And down he goes, right around the 30. That'll make it 35. Got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. And he's immediately tackled.
That was a clutch play on fourth down, but they are still down a couple of scores, and it's going to take some work for this team to get back into this game.
Just under three to go in regulation. Now he's scrambling, and they bring him down for a sack on the play. Defense looking for another sack here on this second and 13 situation. Throws this one away.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. Booming kick. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. And now he's got room to run. He makes his way out to about the 35.
from their own 35-yard line. First down. Runs outside for a nice gain. The Nittany Lions taking their first time out of the half. Just under two to go in the game. He makes his way to about the 48.
The offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 48-yard line. Makes it out to about the 39. So they go on the ground and pick up another first down.
They are stringing together a nice little drive here. If they keep this up, it'll be hard to keep them out of the end zone.
So he decides to hold on to it, and that's going nowhere.
Good job by the junior linebacker to read the run and limit the play to a short gain.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 39. He's at the 30. Tackle around the 27-yard line. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. He'll go down to one knee. Here's the eighth play of the series. This one comes to an end. Our final count in this game, 28-14, Tigers. That brings this broadcast to a close. 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.